Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. My anchor holds within the veil. Christ shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in Him be found, dressed in His righteousness alone, and faultless stand before the throne. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the
amen, amen. Our next song is called Build My Life. And it's an invitation for all of us to build our lives upon the rock, which is Jesus Christ. You know, we need to, oftentimes, you know, there's that story in the Bible that says of someone who built their house on the sand and someone who built their house on the rock. You know, whenever we build our lives on Jesus Christ, we are on solid ground. And we can trust in Him. and we can know that he knows what is best for us, and that wherever there's a storm, whenever the high winds blow in our life, we're gonna stand firm because we're with him, because we're with Jesus. So I invite you all to sing with us this song that says, Build My Life.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. There is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. And I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation, and I will put my trust in you alone. And I will not be ashamed. beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Amen. I want to ask you to stand to sing our opening song this morning. And it's a song that says, I surrender. And I think that all of us have come to this place to worship the Lord, but also to surrender our lives, surrender everything to Him.
Speak to me. I surrender, I wanna know you more, I wanna know you more, I surrender.
We've gathered to share an old story, familiar and dearly loved. Yet somehow every year, the wonder of it all becomes new once more. Our hearts are stirred to celebrate, to sing, to repeat the sounding joy. We find ourselves wanting to say to all who will listen, pay attention, there's something in the air. It's both a whisper from the past and a song of hope for eternity.
said the king to the people everywhere. Listen to what I say. Pray for peace, people everywhere. Listen to what I say.
There was no room in the inn, no room for heaven's amazing gift of love, no room for the long-awaited Messiah, no room for our only hope of salvation, no room. Time and again, these two simple words stir our hearts, and we vow to make sure it never happens with us. Our prayer becomes, Father, don't let me fill Christmas with anything but who Jesus is and the reason he came the way he did.
Come on.
When did the Bethlehem night, the shepherds on the hills, the song of the heavenly host, the scene of the baby asleep in the manger, when did it become the narrative we cherish today? Mary had stored all those memories in her heart for so long, and Luke must have listened in wonder as she recounted every detail. But they couldn't have imagined how every word would lead us back to the manger each year to fall in worship. Noel. It's an ancient word that is synonymous with Christmas. It signifies the Savior's birth. It implies a shout of joy and a song of praise. It calls us to return to the manger to behold the miracle of Emmanuel, God with us. Luke 2:17 and 18 says, "After the shepherds had seen him, they told everyone. They reported what the angel had said about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them." And just like those shepherds, once we find Jesus, once we understand the incredible gift we've been given, we just can't keep it to ourselves. This is good news we have to share. It's Christmas. Jesus has come.
It's Christmas. The angels are singing. And I know the reason. The Savior is born. Heavenly Father, I cannot imagine what it will be like in heaven. Help us all be there. Amen. Thank you.